I'm Dr. Sasha Hamdani. I'm a board-certified psychiatrist, and I've been treating women with ADHD for over 10 years. Today, I'm going to be answering the internet's biggest questions about ADHD and periods. Does ADHD affect periods? ADHD doesn't actually affect periods, but periods can affect ADHD in terms of the hormonal shift. When your estrogen levels drop right before your period, that impacts your dopamine. Since dopamine already plays a really big role in ADHD, this can impact inattention, irritability, and emotional sensitivity. Not a lot of people know that, so that's an important thing to kind of know and reminder to just be kinder to yourself during those times. Can ADHD symptoms fluctuate through the menstrual cycle? Absolutely. So most people notice changes around the luteal phase, which is that period of time right before your period actually starts. This is when your estrogen drops. When your estrogen drops, at the same time, your dopamine is dropping. Now, the issue with that is that people with ADHD already have issues with dopamine dysregulation. So this is where you see irritability, you see emotional sensitivity, and you see increased difficulty with focusing. By the way, the luteal phase is also when you experience PMS symptoms, so you're really getting hit from both sides, which is why it's incredibly challenging. Can PMS be more intense in women with ADHD? Yes, it can. People with ADHD often report heightened PMS symptoms, including irritability, emotional ability, even depressive symptoms. Since emotional regulation is already such a challenge with ADHD, the additional hormonal stress of PMS can heighten everything. Emerging research shows that ADHD and PMDD could be linked. Just to clarify, PMDD is the more severe form of PMS. In short, research is starting to show that ADHD does make you more vulnerable to having mood changes secondary to PMDD. What that might look like is you might be highly emotionally responsive to certain things that maybe wouldn't have bothered you at other times in the month. You might be more tearful than you are at baseline, or you might find yourself much more quick to anger. Does ADHD medication affect menstrual symptoms? ADHD medication doesn't impact menstrual symptoms directly, but there are some nuanced connections. Like, for example, if you're on a stimulant medication for ADHD, you can sometimes see an appetite suppression, which can impact your energy and your mood around your cycle. On the flip side, sometimes people note that during certain phases of their menstrual cycle, that their ADHD medication doesn't feel like it's working quite as well. If you are noticing that, make sure you take good notes and try to figure out when the changes are happening and what is actually happening to your medication, because if you bring it up with your physician, they're going to be able to talk with you and find ways to accommodate. Can hormonal birth control help regulate ADHD symptoms? So in some cases, yes, hormonal birth control can help alleviate some of those fluctuations that happen with ADHD. How this might show up is that you might notice that hormonal birth control, if it is helping, it can help with some of the emotional and cognitive challenges brought by these changes in hormones for ADHD. Having said that, everybody responds differently. Some people it really helps, and some people it makes them more emotional and scattered. So it's really important to talk to a provider and figure out what's going to work for you. And if you're looking for more resources about ADHD and periods, we have a lot more, including articles and a period tracker. Check out the description below for links. Why do I feel more impulsive and distracted during my period? So with hormonal changes, especially that time before your period, those lower levels of estrogen impact the lower levels of dopamine. Dopamine is in charge of your executive functioning and processing and emotional regulation. So if you're already struggling with that, you might feel like that time before your period, you have a harder time managing your impulsivity. For me, that time before my period, I noticed a pretty steady correlation between that and my spending habits because I would just be relaxing in the evenings and mindlessly scrolling on my phone and ordering things. Once I noticed that pattern and realized there was a correlation, I was able to kind of course correct and take some of that credit card info off my phone so I wouldn't have it so readily accessible, which is why it's so important to track your patterns so that you can see where your holes are and then take action. Is brain fog during my period related to ADHD or hormones? It's both. Hormonal fluctuations, especially that drop in estrogen, can exacerbate ADHD symptoms. A lot of people notice that their luteal phase, the time right before your period, is when their brain fog and fogginess in general gets the worst. It's not just in your head. This is why tracking your patterns can be so helpful in terms of understanding them and then later managing them. For people that are experiencing pretty significant brain fog, this is something you could talk about with your doctor. There are many different ways you can go about this to help alleviate some of the symptoms, and that can range from just behavioral things to possibly looking for hormonal answers or even looking for changing your medications to help in that period. Can tracking period cycles help manage ADHD symptoms? Yes, it can. Not only does it give you a clearer picture of how your hormones fluctuate during your cycle and how that impacts your focus, but it can help you plan ahead. If you know certain phases of your cycle can bring about more focus, challenges, or mood swings, you can be more intentional about your schedule to build in more supports. For example, you could do things like if you know that that week before your period is really difficult for you, trying to schedule big meetings outside of that window. You can also utilize that time premenstrually and start to shift your focus towards more restorative things like self-care. What should I tell my doctor if I think my ADHD symptoms and periods are connected? This is when it's so important to talk to your doctor about your patterns and what you've noticed. Bring a symptom tracker if you have one. Bring a calendar if you have one. This is when you want to gather as much data as possible. Talk about your focus. Talk about your mood. Talk about your productivity. Talk about your impulsivity. Any other factor that you think might be important for that connection so that they can help you and figure out what intervention would be best if there is an intervention to be made. That could be medication timing, hormone management, or figuring out ways that you can behaviorally modify your schedule. One thing I want to note is that this is so important to talk about because number one, nobody talks about this. And number two, because there's such limited data on women's health, which makes it so hard to get the right help and figure out what the next steps are. Hey, thanks so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, we actually have a lot more content like this on our channel, so make sure to subscribe. By doing so, you can help to further Understood's mission, which is to make sure that the 70 million people with learning and thinking differences like ADHD and dyslexia can thrive.